Hello and welcome to Tech School. Today we will learn how to customize a terminal app to make it look more interesting. So this is a default look of the terminal app on my Mac. It's pretty boring with a white background and black text. So let's add more color to it. First, open the browser and search for Oh My Zsh. Here it is. Let's scroll down a bit. There are some installation instructions over here. As you can see, we need to have Zsh shell installed. We can check that by running this command. Normally on a Mac, it should already be pre-installed. Similarly, we can check if curl and git is installed or not. Alright, so everything is ready. Now we just go ahead to copy and run this command in the terminal. And we're done. Now if we run ls, we will see some colors. It looks better than before. But I'm not satisfied, so let's do a little trick to the theme. Open the terminal menu, preference, then on the background, we select color and effect. First, change the opacity to about 90% to make it a bit transparent. Then update the blur. It's up to you. But for me, I prefer to be able to see and read what's behind the terminal window. So I set it to 0%. Now move the slider to the darker side and change the color to whatever you like. For me, I will use some kind of blue here. Now the black text is quite hard to read on this background. So I'm gonna change it to white. Both normal and bold text. Excellent. It looks great, but the default window size is too small. I will make it bigger. Let's say 128 columns and 32 rows. Perfect. There's one last but very important thing that we should do. Because now we are using Zsh shell, some of our startup commands in the bus profile or bus RC file won't be loaded whenever we start the terminal or open a new tab. So let's use Vim to update this file to tell Zsh shell to load the bus profile and bus RC file for us. Press I to enter the insert mode. Then type in these two commands and we're done. Basically, it will check if bus profile and bus RC exist or not and run them if they do. By the way, since we are in this file, you can see that we are using the default theme, Robbie Russell, which is the name of the original author of Zsh shell. There are many other themes that you can find in this link. You can try them if you like. It's very simple. Just replace the name of the theme, save the file, and restart the terminal. I'm not gonna do that because I like the default one. So I will save this file by pressing escape, then colon WQ, enter. Then restart the terminal. And voila, we're all set. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Happy coding, and I will see you in other lectures of Tech School.